Hello and welcome to this video on creating your first certificate. This video will give you the basics to start creating your first certificate. Okay, let us start by going to Create Cert. Here you can add certificates as favourites by clicking the star. You can also see how many certificate numbers you have, and if you need any more, you can purchase your certificates by clicking the trolley icon, which will direct you to the NICEIC website to purchase certificate numbers for that type of certificate. Next, click on the certificate you require. In this case, I'm going for the DCR 18 certificate. Now we're in the certificate, let's explain the navigation tools. You can use the arrows here to move between pages or select the required page by selecting the page menu button. If you need to zoom in or out, you can do so with the zoom icons. First, you will see your contractor details. You can edit these in the address book if needed. However, they should have been added during the setup. Now let's add a customer. So here you can search your address book or add a new customer by clicking on the plus icon. The same goes for the installation address. Just select or add a new installation address. Okay, let's talk about filling in some of the details on the certificate. In the part 2 section, you can tick boxes, select dates, and type the text you require in the text box. Part 4 is where you can add signatures. Do this by clicking on the signature menu button and selecting a signature or capture a signature. In this case, I've selected capture and drawn the signature. Let's go to the next page and show how to tick, cross or NA boxes. You can either cycle through by left clicking to the one you require or right click and select the result you require. To make things easier on the schedule of inspection page, you can use the set all feature. Either cycle through by left clicking or right click and select your result. Okay, now let's add some circuits to the board on the circuit details page. So first you can add the amount you want by clicking on the plus sign here. Alternatively, you can click on the three dots next to shortcut keys and use the circuit wizard. Here you can select the phase, the number of circuits, the circuit start number and the format. Also, the ability to split the board. Just click Generate Preview and then Create Circuits. Now we have a list of circuits you can start to fill them in. I'll start to fill in the circuit details with a circuit description and a type of wiring. Next, I'm going to use a shortcut key to fill in all the other circuits with the same result in type of wiring by pressing F5. There are many shortcut keys, just press shortcut keys to understand what they do. My favourite is the F5 and F6 keys. This should help make it quicker to fill in your certificates. To add more boards, click on the plus sign here. To delete a board, click the subtraction icon. Before we move on to the test page, you will see the circuit you are working on highlighted in blue. If we go to the test page, that highlight stays on the test page and the selected circuit will populate the circuit you're working on and display the circuit description. Now let's look at finishing the certificate. Go to the tools, you can see an option to fill in all blank entries with NA. This is useful for any fields that may have been left blank because they are not applicable. Now we can complete the certificate by selecting complete. We can then look to print or email it to a customer by clicking on print and selecting original. You will now see the certificate with your desired logo to give it a professional look. To print, just click on the print icon, and then to email from the print, click the PDF icon, and from the PDF, select the email icon. That's it for creating your first certificate. If you are interested in any one-to-one training sessions, please get in touch with your account manager for further details, who can be contacted on 0117 902 2012. Thanks for listening.